assemblers, carpenters, bricklayers, the town layers, the plumbers. In Ghana, if you're building, you're looking for these artisans, you ain't gonna get their names. You get some, but they're all from Togo. Why? Because we don't have a TVET program that rewards people. Even if you want to be a carpenter, you learn from the side of the road, from your uncle or a gentleman from within the village. So there's no certification. Now, government is embarking on a TVET program to train artisans. Believe me, for people who put up these wooden things on the wall, do you know how much they make? It's a whole lot of money. Plumbing. You have a home. I know most of you may have a home. If in the night you have problems with your electricity, there's nobody to call. Nothing. If you want plumbing, your pipe is broken, forget about it. Then you're going to swim in the water in the night. So these are areas that we actually cultivating. How do we bring people to train them? I had a cousin who was selling graphic newspapers in Ghana. Came to New York. Gradually went to school on and on and on. Later on, he became a construction guru, sitting there on the road, supervising white guys to do the road. We need that kind of artisanal capacity, because unless we build a capacity level, welders, our gas industry, the welding community, it's all Nigerians and Burkina-based and others, no Ghanaians. So if we know of our children, grandchildren, nephews, and nieces and all in Ghana or elsewhere, let's bring them home. Let's bring them in, or let them learn how to do these artisanal jobs. Because now we, Private Enterprise Federation has been able to put together the construction industry as a construction chamber. From the first guy who picks the stone to the guy who does the roofing. The surveyors, the architects, the engineers, and the electricians and all have come together as a construction industry. They're now looking at how do we build the technical competence and expertise, the specialization in that industry. This is what I want us to do. Because if you start education, look at educational levels, 700,000 students start from the grade. My high school is only 350,000. 350,000 fell by the roadside. There are no avenues for them to educate themselves. The other 350, when they're going to university, it's only 65,000 left. What happened to the rest? So we have to be looking from within that these are areas that are easy to come by. Agriculture, I mentioned before. We don't even have farm managers. We think agriculture is just cutlass and hoe. But now mechanization, storage facilities, river transportation, there are a whole lot of things. And to me, I'm not going to bore you, but if you are willing to get a lot more information, go to him, come to us, Private Enterprise Federation, we'll share our knowledge with you down the road.